Hi everyone, Natalie here with All Four Paws of West Palm Beach, and today I'm here working with my friend Maddie. Maddie and I today want to show you how to make it a positive experience for your dog to have their harness put on. So some dogs really dislike having their harness put on. I think there are several different reasons. Sometimes dogs don't like something coming at them over their head. Sometimes it's sensitivity issues where the harness is touching their body. So some dogs find it unpleasant to be touched. So you can see how when I pet Maddie there, she sort of shrieked back. It's a little unpleasant for her. And we can change that association by using positive reinforcement with clicker training and some yummy treats. So I'm going to go through the steps here and show you a couple ways that you can build towards having a better experience with your dog having their harness put on. First thing I just want to show you, you trying to steal my treats? Come here, silly girl. The first thing I want to show you is just Maddie's response to having her harness put on. So if I go towards her with it, she backs away. So you can see that this is not something that she enjoys. I'm going to change that with a couple steps. The first thing I like to do is take the harness and put it on the ground and place a couple treats on it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to reward Maddie for touching the harness. So I'm going to put a treat here on the harness, and then I'm going to click and treat for her eating the food off of the harness. Now Maddie's really fast and food motivated, so I'm going to put a treat over here just to sort of distract her for a second. I'm going to place a treat there. Yes, good girl. And I'm clicking and treating for Maddie eating the food off the harness. So same thing, I'm just going to kind of lure her away so I have a second to place the treat there. Yes, good girl. Okay, you go through that several repetitions. I would recommend 15 to 20 in the beginning. And then the next step, what I like to do is I like to try to change the association the dog has of being touched with something positive. So I'm touching Maddie on her body where the harness would go, and I'm clicking and then offering her a treat, a food reward. Good girl. And again, same thing, I would go through that 15 to 20 times until you practice this several times, you'll see some progress and improvement with your dog and their response to these things. Good girl. Next thing I would go through is using the harness to touch the dog's body. Same thing, I would click and treat. If it's too much coordination for you to use the clicker, you feel like it's too close to the dog, you can either muffle it with your hand or with some packing tape, or you can use a marker word like yes or yep. So I'm gonna do it with the clicker, and I'm going to just, good girl, touch the sides of Maddie's body with the harness and click and treat. Come here. She really doesn't like it, so if I need to lure her with a treat in order to get her over to do it, that's fine. Good girl, yay! And then I have her over here, same thing. I would go through that 15 to 20 times. I would go through touching the dog on the sides of the body where the harness is going to be in contact and clicking and treating. The next thing I like to do is I want the dog to love every aspect of the harness, including the sounds that it makes. So I'm gonna use the clasp as sort of like a clicker. And every time I close it and it makes that click sound, I'm gonna give Maddie a treat, good girl. So I'm going to close it again. Yes, good dog. And we're not really doing anything particular here so much as just getting Maddie to associate something good with even the way the sound of the harness goes. Good girl. Go through that again 15 to 20 times. And then the next step is I would open the harness as wide as possible where the dog would be putting their head through. And what I like to do is take a treat and have the dog come through the harness. Yes, good girl. The important thing about this exercise, this part of the exercise, is that I keep this hand stationary. So I do not move the hand that holds the harness, and I allow the dog to make the choice of putting their face through the harness. So in the beginning, if you hold the treat, you'll notice your dog might not offer going through. If you have to lure your dog through like this with a treat, that's completely fine. So long as you make sure that this hand holding the harness is still, it's okay if you use the treat to move, good girl, to get them to come all the way through the harness. So you can see every time this is Maddie's choice. I'm not forcing it on her, I'm not moving the harness towards her or anything like that. After you do this 15 to 20 times, you could raise the criteria and see if the dog will offer the behavior on their own to get the reward. So dogs, being so smart, know to offer behaviors that have been rewarded, and I just rewarded Maddie several times for this behavior. So it's possible that she would, if you wait and are patient, she would offer that behavior on her own just to get the treat. So let's see if Maddie does it. Close, Maddie. What do you think I need you to do? Yes. Yeah, good girl. So she was really close there and I wanted her to get a success. So I just made a little kissy sound and tried to entice her a little bit. The next step you could take, is you could fade out the lure. So I would pretend like I have a treat to lure her through. And if you go through this exercise where you want to fade out the lure, you can change it into a hand signal like this, or a word, a verbal cue such as through. And that would indicate the dog to put their head through the harness. So I would use food, and if I do this 10 times, maybe 8 times out of 10 I use food, and 2 times I don't. So this time I'm going to pretend I have a treat, and I'm going to lure Maddie through. Yes, good girl. Now I am still going to reward her. However, instead of using the food to lure her in, I'm giving her the treat as reward afterwards for the behavior. So same thing, I'm going to pretend I have a treat. I'm going to lure Maddie through. Yes, good girl. Now remember, Maddie still gets the treat while the harness is on. But because she's gone through this exercise a little bit, I can raise the criteria to fading the lure and treating her afterwards. So that time I gave her food, do it again with food. Yes, good girl. And then this time I'm gonna pretend I have food. So I'm gonna pretend I have a treat, same process. Yay, good girl. Give her the treat afterwards. The next thing you could do is you could just feed the dog while the harness is on. You could do it while you also touch the dog's body where the harness is. Do that 10 to 15 times, or 15 to 20, depending on how your dog's doing. And then you can go into starting to close the harness. Good girl, Maddie. Yeah. So maybe in the beginning, you just kind of open and close it and feed treats. Good girl. I like to give the treat after I've closed the harness. So I'm gonna go like this. Yes, good dog. Good girl. Could do that again 15 to 20 times. And then you can start leaving the harness on for short increments. Maybe it's 10 seconds to begin with, then you take it off, put it back on, do 15 seconds, take it off, put it back on for 5 seconds, give her an easy one, take it off, put it back on for 20 seconds, and then you can get the dog to start wearing the harness as well if that's an issue. So I hope this was helpful to everybody. Feel free to give me a thumbs up if you liked the information, if you liked my video. You can also share it if you know somebody that might be helped by the information, and subscribe to my page if you want to receive all my videos. Thanks for tuning in, everybody, and happy training. Take care. Good job, Maddie. Good girl. Yay. Good girl.